fading. I'm your knight in shining armor, and I love you. You have made me what I am, and I'm yours. My love, there's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms forevermore. You have gone and made me such a fool. I'm so lost in your love. And oh, belong together. Won't you believe in my song? Lady, for so many years I thought I'd never find you. You have come into my life and made me whole. Oh, forever, let me wake to see you each and every morning. Let me hear you whisper softly in my ear. In my eyes, I see no one else but you. There's no other love like our love. And oh, yes, girl, I'll always want you.
Well, friends and family, we know that Rachel and Eric are here today to get married and that they are perfect for each other. Today is a day of tremendous joy and celebration, and as we celebrate, we're mindful of those who can't be here with us today, but who are unable to be physically present. They're in our hearts and minds and here with us in spirit, and we're grateful to them and mindful of them in all that is happening here today. Friends, how did we end up here today? How did these two people somehow not only end up meeting, but also end up falling in love and choosing to spend the rest of their lives together? I'd like to spend the next few minutes telling you one of the true story versions of how Rachel and Eric got here today. Our story begins on a day just like any other, and as modern day love stories often do, online. Our protagonists, Rachel and Eric, in search of their forever person, swipe right on each other and a natural conversation ensues. Eric is captivated by her beauty and wants to know Rachel even more. Rachel is intrigued by the pictures Eric has chosen to display and can just tell he's the life of the party. They chat back and forth and their conversation is begging to be taken offline. Eric, feeling a little brave, decides to send Rachel a text. Hey, what are you doing? Want to meet for coffee? He types and then waits. It's a bit of a gamble, but Eric's feeling lucky. Within minutes, his phone buzzes with a reply. It's Rachel, and her answer is, sure. They agree to meet at Starbucks. His heart skips a beat. Eric, with a sudden rush of excitement, hops into his car and heads towards Middletown. He doesn't know it yet, but each mile he drives brings him closer to meeting the woman who will become his best friend and the love of his life. And there you have it, a regular day turns into a day of destiny. Rachel and Eric are sitting in Starbucks, and the aroma of coffee fills the air as they chat. They're both really into the conversation. It's like they've known each other for years. There's a spark in the air, something that can't be denied. They laugh, share stories, and enjoy each other's company. Rachel suddenly asks Eric what his plans are for the Super Bowl. Eric shrugs and says he has no plans. Rachel's eyes light up and she invites him over to her place to watch the game together. Eric arrives at Rachel's place and they settle in to watch the game. Rachel, the gracious host, serves him some chicken. Eric takes a bite and as a great guest, he tries to hide his distaste. While the chicken may not have been to his liking, Rachel's presence and warmth supersedes it all. He's all smiles to be in her company, as she is. As they watch the game, Rachel's pool numbers come up and she wins $750. She is ecstatic and turns to Eric, nicknaming him her good luck charm, and promises to take him out to dinner the next week. The following Tuesday, Rachel keeps her promise. She takes Eric to Outback for dinner. They share a lovely evening filled with laughter and good food. Their connection deepens, and it is clear this spark is everlasting. And that date leads to the next, and soon Rachel and Eric are building a life and a future together. Rachel and Eric have talked about taking their relationship to the next level. While marriage has become a natural topic of conversation, Rachel's absolutely clueless about when the proposal will be. Rachel and Eric are now on their way to visit Rachel's brother and sister-in-law for the holidays. Eric seems a bit more nervous than usual. Rachel chalks it up to his dislike for flying. Even in the week leading up to the trip, they're not sure if they're going to fly. But unknown to Rachel, the real reason for Eric's nerves isn't the flight, but rather a small, shiny object he's secretly carrying with him. He's got a ring and a big question to ask. They make it to Alabama all safe and sound. Eric knows how much Rachel's family means to her, so he wants them all there when it happens. Eric finds a moment to pull Rachel's family aside, one at a time, and tells them he's planning on proposing. Rachel, oblivious to the unfolding events, is busy peeling potatoes for dinner, her hands smeared with potato skin and turning an odd shade of red. It's not exactly the best look for an engagement ring. As they all sit on the couch, everyone thinks the proposal will happen after dinner, but Eric can't wait. He's too nervous. He tells Rachel's sister-in-law, Lauren, that he's going to do it. Lauren, fully prepared, starts recording. Rachel's mother catches on and calls her dad, who's busy grilling outside. Quick, come in, it's happening. In all the excitement, Eric pops the question. The problem, half the family misses it because they weren't expecting it too soon. So in a turn of events that could only happen in a love story like this, they decide to do a redo. There's Eric down on one knee, saying sweet things neither can quite remember, surrounded by Rachel's joyful family, and he asks, Rachel, will you marry me? Excitedly and through tears of joy, Rachel says yes for the second time. And here we are today. Can we give it up for Rachel and Eric? Yay! This is a beautiful story. It's a story of two people crossing paths, intentionally nurturing a connection, who took the time to cultivate mutual care and attention to intertwine their two stories into one. It is because of moments in this story and many others that Eric can say of Rachel when I ask him what he loves about her. Everything about Rachel says love to me. I love that she is a passionate person. I love her caring and empathetic soul. She is motivational and supports me in every way. I love that she is kind, even when I fall short. She gives me more confidence, and I'm better because she's in my life. If I could have married Rachel yesterday, I would have. I'm so sure of the strength of our relationship, and I know without a doubt that Rachel is my partner for life. Like two jigsaw pieces that complete the final picture, we're finally home. And Rachel says of Eric, when I ask her what she loves about him, I love everything about Eric. I love his amazing blue eyes that light up a room. I love the way he not only listens to me, but makes me feel heard. The best part of coming home every day is being with him. I love his hugs and kisses and the way he can get me to laugh and smile, even on my worst days. I love the way he looks at me and how it can make me forget why I'm upset in the first place. I've always dreamed of being married, and I'm so happy that I can experience that reality with the person I truly love. I'm ready to enjoy all the ups together and come out stronger, even through the downs. Eric is my confidant, my best friend, and the one I want to spend the rest of my life with. Now, Rachel and Eric are in love, and two people in love do tend to gush about each other, but as the opinions of family and friends are perhaps a bit more objective, I asked a few friends and family about Rachel and Eric. Here's what you had to say. Rachel and Eric fit each other like a glove. I love the way they communicate and support each other, even through tough times, always ensuring they never go to bed angry. I love how their personalities complement each other perfectly, bringing out the best in one another and tending to each other's needs. Rachel's kindness and thoughtfulness are evident in the way she cares for Eric, while Eric has explored his interests more deeply with Rachel's support. I love that their shared interests make them incredibly compatible and keep them close. Rachel keeps Eric grounded, and I look forward to witnessing the great adventures they will continue to embark on together and watching their love grow every day. Friends, the most important thing about today, about a wedding, about what makes us all come together in this heat, in suits and gowns and less than comfortable dancing shoes, is what happens in the moments here to follow. Today is like no other in the story of Rachel and Eric because they've invited us here to observe and to witness and to celebrate what their love story has inspired. Promise. How they've grown together and come to this moment where they want to say to each other, I will be the person who is always here for you. I commit to loving you faithfully for as many years as we have left on this earth. So today, Rachel and Eric, you're here to say publicly to us and to each other that the bond that starts to take root from your very first meeting, through Super Bowl games and joyful time spent with family, in all your mundane moments and exciting excursions, that bond you commit to keep strengthening from this day forward. And so having said all that, Rachel and Eric, do you stand here today to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We do.
Yes, give it up for Rachel and Eric! This is the heart of the ceremony, the part of the day when Rachel and Eric break new ground into their relationships by making promises to each other, traditionally called vows. Eric, please repeat after me. I, Eric.
Take you, Rachel.
To be my wife. My life partner and friend. To join my life with yours. To share
with you all that is to be.
To laugh with you in joy. To comfort you in sorrow. To grow with you in love. I will honor you. I will be faithful to you. All the days of my life. This is my sacred vow. Rachel, please repeat after me. I, Rachel. Take you, Eric.
To be my husband.
My life partner and friend.
To join my life with yours.
To share with you all that is to be.
To laugh with you in joy.
To comfort you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
I will honor you.
I'll be faithful to you.
All the days of my life.
This is my vow.
Rachel and Eric will now exchange rings as a symbol of the promises they've made here today and of their ongoing commitment to each other. Andy, please bring the ring forward. Eric, please repeat after me. Rachel, I give you this ring.
As a reminder.
That I will love and honor you.
Please wear it as a sign.
Of my commitment to you. All right, Andy, please bring the ring forward. I
I think it's the other one? Okay. Yes. Sorry. My bad. Okay.
Rachel, please repeat after me. Eric, I give you this ring.
Eric, I give you this ring.
As a reminder.
As a reminder.
That I will love and honor you.
That I will love and honor you.
Please wear it as a sign.
Please wear it as a sign.
Of my commitment to you.
Of my commitment to you.
All right, Rachel and Eric, you've just made a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other. Your growing relationship can be put into a symbol by pouring sand. But we also acknowledge that in marriage, we're not just coming together as individuals, we're coming together and uniting in community, particularly in two family stories blending together as well. All right, as you each hold your sand, the separate colors represent your lives up to this moment and your families, individual and unique. Please, let me open this up for you. You're gonna pour yours in. There we go. Ahead.
Me?
Yes.
I spilled some.
Of course you did.
As you combine your sand together, we have this wonderful symbol of how your lives join together today as one. Just as these colors can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, the same is true of your marriage and your family. None of you will ever lose your uniqueness. You never lose who you are. At the same time, the merging of your lives and stories will never again be separable. And today you're creating something new and beautiful. Let's give it up for the new family. Rachel and Eric, with great joy, in front of all your closest friends and family, by the authority given to me by the state of New York, I pronounce you husband and wife. Eric, you may kiss your bride. On behalf of Rachel and Eric and their families, thank you so much for celebrating with us. Can you party as hard as these two are in love tonight? Friends and family, please stand with us now. It is my distinct honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Roach!
Sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the softly smile, I know she must be kind. In her eyes, she goes with me to a blossom room. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me thank you.
Gentlemen, are you ready for the parents? Make some noise! I would like to introduce to you the bride's parents. Let's give it up for Debbie and Rick Lincoln! Ah, yeah, there they go. Come on, everybody, give it up for the parents of the bride. Congratulations! At this time, I would like to introduce to you the groom's mother. Let's give it up for Doreen Roach. We gonna celebrate your party with you. Come on. Yes, put those hands together, everybody. Come on, make some noise for Doreen. Congratulations. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the parents here this evening. Nice round of applause for the parents. Come on, give it up for them. And at this time, we're going to introduce to you the wedding party. Are we ready? Make some noise out there. Ah, yeah, rock and rollers, here we go. Introducing the bridesmaid, let's give it up. Sophia Roach, escorted by the groomsman, Brody Baker. You show us everything you've got. You keep on dancing and the room gets hot. You drive us wild, we'll drive you crazy. Ah, yeah, we got the bridesmaid, Gianna Roach, come on. Yes, and we got the groomsman in the house, where's Trace Baker? Oh yeah, bridesmaid, where's she? Gianna Roach, everybody, come on. Oh yeah, here we go, groomsman in the house. Yes, come on. Okay, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna go with the bridesmaids then. Here we go, let's give it up. Here we go, come on. Ladies and gentlemen, Lisa Hennigan, come on! Let's give it up for the bridesmaid, Lauren Lincoln! Oh yeah, let's give it up, here we go! We got the flower girl, Abigail Lincoln! Yes, give it up for the flower girl! Oh yeah, we got the maid of honor in the house, maid of honor, Ashley Lincoln! Oh yeah, here we go, we got the groomsman in the house, Brody Baker! Oh, here we go! We got Trace out here ready. We got Frank Roach and Alan Lincoln and the best man, Andrew Peacock! And ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the wedding party! Come on, make some noise. And at this time, I'd ask everybody to please rise if you're able to stand, because yes, we're going to be introducing, yes, the newlyweds. Let's go, everybody. I want you to get those hands clapping. Come on, let's go. Candle, come on, clap those hands, everybody. I don't hear those hands. Let's go. I don't think the bride and groom hear those hands. Let's go. Come on. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and great pleasure to introduce to you the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Roach. Let's go, make some noise, everybody. Come on. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a nice round of applause for Eric and Rachel. Congratulations. Ah, yeah, Eric, I'd like you to escort your lovely wife to the center of the dance floor. Yes, at this time, let's have all the couples here this evening join Eric and Rachel.
Thank you.
Let's have a nice round of applause, everybody. The newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Roach. Their wedding song on their wedding day. Congratulations from everybody here this evening, and thank you, couples, for joining them. Yeah, come on, sing it, she goes.
Goes out with other guys, here's the moral and the story from the guy who knows. I fell in love and my love still grows. Ask any fool that she ever knew to say, I keep away from her, run around to a play that out. Yeah, keep away from this girl. I know what you'll do. Keep away.
Ah, yeah, keep it out there on the dance floor. We're going to rock around the clock here this evening. Come on up, dancers. Join them on the D floor.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad rags on. Join me home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes. We're going to rock around.
Here we go.
When the chimes ring 5, 6, and 7, we'll be right in 7th heaven. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
Keep it going. Let's go, hands up. Come on, get those hands up. Clap those hands, everybody. Come on. Yeah, sing it, ladies. Let's go. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, go. Oh yeah, who's out there next? There we go, the flower girl. Yeah, let's give it up for the flower girl in the house. Who's out there next? Who's gonna work it? No shame tonight. Come on, who's out there?
this way.
Oh yeah, get those hands up, everybody. Come on, hands up, get those hands up. Clap those hands, let's go. Ladies, come on, sing it. I'm the best. Say what? Hey, come on, sing it. Everybody. I can't hear it. I do. I hear you. Come on. Everybody. Oh yeah, let's go. Come on. Go, go, go. Let's have a nice round of applause for Rachel and her father, Rick. Congratulations!
I took my love and I took it down. I climbed a mountain and I turned around. And I saw is love. and the child within my heart rise above. Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my life? I don't know. Well, I've been afraid of changing, 'cause I built my life around you. But time made you bolder, children get older, and I'm getting older too. So but time makes you bolder, children get older, I'm getting older too. I'm getting older too. So take this love, take it down. Oh, if you climb a mountain and you turn around, if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, where the landslide will bring it down, down. And if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, the landslide.
Let's have a nice round of applause one more time, everybody, for Eric and his mother, Doreen. Congratulations from everybody here this evening.
And we must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine. I've got it all here in my heart.
Let's have a nice round of applause, everybody, for Rachel and her mother, Debbie. Congratulations.
Hi, everyone. So I know most of you, but for those who don't, I'm Rachel's younger sister, Ashley. Really happy to be here today and getting weirdly emotional, so sorry in advance. Rachel, you are truly one of the most genuine, caring, loving people that I know. We may fight from time to time. We're sisters, it happens. But we always make up, and that's what sisters do. And your heart is too big for me not to ever. While we may have our differences, I love dance, you quit when you started. I love the city, you love the lake. I'm a Yankees fan, you're a Mets fan. Listen. We can forget the Subway Series this week. It's okay, guys. It's okay. I love to travel. You and Eric hate airplanes. But all that said, I'm very lucky to have you as my sister. I know there's many of your coworkers out here tonight who can attest to the person that you are. To choose a profession such as teaching, not only just teaching, but special education and elementary school, speaks to your heart and character more than words can ever say. You should all also know that I did Junior Achievement Teach for a Day once with seventh graders in June, and I texted Rachel after that saying, I'm sorry for anything I've ever said about you having your summers off, because never again, and I chose the right profession, and you chose the right profession. I'm truly in awe of the way in which you care so deeply and passionately for your students, and any questions from your friends asking on behalf of their children, for your family, your friends, and everyone around you. I'm so happy to see your smile shine so bright today. Eric, take care of my sister. You two similarly have your differences and things in common. Rachel weirdly became a Mets fan. We really don't know how that happened. But I'm really happy that you two together go see baseball games and you have that common love. You travel everywhere and go to each other's concerts. You compromised on the music today and compromised through a lot. But you're here for each other, and that's what makes me really happy. So Eric, take care of my sister's beautiful and genuine heart, and welcome to the family. So if we could all raise a glass and cheers to Rachel and Eric.
Thank you. All right, thank you so much. As he said, I'm Andy Piak. I've known Eric for close to 30 years now. We attended Plattsburgh State University together, and actually speaking in front of all these people reminds me of the one class that we shared together, public speaking. And being good friends, of course, we sat next to each other, and we immediately, you know, gave some nicknames to other classmates, Old Lady Goop, Cider Girl, Queen Scurve, Jennifer Insomnia, her speeches were pretty boring. And we even had a signal when one of our colleagues was particularly struggling up there, and he's probably doing it right now. It was a little tug on the ear, yeah, so. Anyway, I think that was the only class that we shared together at Plattsburgh in the 2 years that we went to college, but just the first of many shared memories over the last 30 years. Concerts, baseball games, just overall just being a good friend. Definitely my best friend that I've ever had, and I truly, truly appreciate that. And over the, you know, our friendship has stayed constant. And, you know, a few years ago, I think we all know at times, Eric can be a bit high maintenance. And when it happened, he became single. I talked to my wife, and I'm like, we might have to clean out our guest room, because Eric might have to stay with us for a while. But then I heard he met a new woman. And then I met Rachel, and I immediately could tell that her personality, her warmth, her kindness, her patience were a perfect match for you. And over the last 5 years, I've seen their love grow, and here we are today. So before anyone starts tugging on their ears, let's raise a glass for Eric and Rachel. Yeah. All right.
I'm just going to speak very briefly. I want to thank all of you for coming today to celebrate this occasion. We are thrilled to have Eric join our family and also Sophia and Gigi. Welcome. I'm going to be the one that keeps a short speech, but I'm also up here because if he starts to say a lot, I'm pulling him out. But really, we hope that you're having a wonderful time. We are so glad again that you're here with us because this is very special to us. So thank you and congratulations. And let's toast again to my son-in-law and daughter. May you be blessed with a wonderful life. Bless you.
Yep,
okay, thank you. Keep it short, Rick. I'm pulling you out.
I have nothing to offer to that. Having said all that, many, many, many thanks. I agree with Deb for being here. This is a lovely occasion. Also, I do want to give a warm thank you to the staff of Walk Hill Golf Club. Their reputation for good food and good drinks and good staff and good people have really preceded them. And guess what? I think we all can agree they lived up to that reputation.
We looked at each other before and we said, are we having a good time? Yeah, we are. So we hope you join us in love.
Having said all that, Rachel's grandfather would love to celebrate all good times with his grandchildren. And he used to have a saying that, you bring me Simcha, which is loosely translated to be joy and celebration. I think we can truly recognize that being here tonight with you two is quite a Simcha. You are giving us joy and celebration. Thank you for being here. We love being able to be with people, sharing good times, sharing good foods, sharing drink, sharing dancing, having a lovely time. This is what life is all about. So I absolutely bow to the two of you. You have given us quite a nice Simcha. Thank you very, very much. I do have to thank this other young lady here who has been out of her way to decide that, gee, Rachel said, Mom, Dad, you're bored. You have nothing good in life. Maybe you would like to give us a nice occasion. You can make homemade decorations for us. You can make table decorations. You can make better fish decorations. You can make the table design. You can make candles. You can make the card decorations. Obviously, thank you for giving Mom something to do. We do appreciate all that. What was that? Yeah, we love the fish.
You will have the opportunity to win the fish, you know, on the table. But we've done a lot of research, and I used to be the volunteer director at Orange Regional Medical Center, and I did the fish 1 year for our volunteer recognition dinner, and the volunteers love the fish. So when Rachel decided that she wanted to do this and she wanted this theme, we step forward and do it. So we did research. So if you happen to be the one that win or will take home your fish, and you don't have to, they really are kind of easy, but we've included everything in a little bag about how to take care of me with a letter from the fish.
So that you people can take the fish home and without having the water go
all over the place.
Let me
and
tell
what
you,
do.
She's done everything.
So we hope if it comes your way that you will do it. But we did really love doing this because, again, this was something that was important to them. And I also suggest when you're up, come and take a look at this cake. This cake is incredible. It just goes with their theme. So, again, we love you both. We bless you. Thank you so much for coming with us.
Thank you for trying to shut me up. I do appreciate that. I do have to recognize that in all is said and done, you would think at this point I should be talking about Rachel and Eric, But Lo, I think we would all be wrong. I have to give a warm thank you, and I don't know where they're sitting, but Rachel has married into an instant family. So thank you very much to Sophia and Gianna, wherever you guys are. You guys have been You guys have been absolutely wonderful in welcoming Rachel to your new family. So we thank you very, very much. I, on a personal note, will also thank you that you have been very kind to me and putting up with my sarcasm. So I do appreciate that. Although, I think you've had a few years of practice putting up with this young man over here. So, with all that said in mind, I will move on. Rachel, and I feel terrible that the officiant was wonderful tonight. Absolutely wonderful choice. The only issue I have with her is she took away half my speech tonight. So I feel terrible that I'm gonna kind of condense a lot of what I said, and I'm sure my wife will be thankful for that, but be that as it may. Rachel, change is wonderful. You have grown to be from a young lady, a young girl, into a very warm and generous and caring young lady. I absolutely respect you for that. Having said that, I can't even read.
You're good.
What? Sorry. Wait, no, no.
You're good.
I'm going to finish. Rachel, when I has, no, I'm going to go on. I owe you yet. Rachel Lincoln I watched Rachel grow up from a young girl being very, very shy and very, very generous with her time and being fumbling when she was in school and dropping her pencils and dropping her books, and she becomes the young, superb teacher that you are today of young kids. I am absolutely in awe of you for your work. You are absolutely wonderful in that. I've watched the same young lady, I'm gonna skip a little bit, but I watched the same young lady who, when I used to coach her in soccer, would tell her, stay on this spot, this is your spot, you own it, do not move from this spot.
You're good,
no,
you're good.
And having said that, the young lady that didn't like athletics becomes a young half marathoner. She runs half marathons now. She becomes an avid exerciser, and she becomes a tremendous person that loves Orange Theory, which is a severe exercise program. Now I get to talk about Eric.
Okay, nobody can hear you, so either stop talking or put the mic to your mouth.
Oh, now I get to talk about Eric.
Good.
Eric, I have absolutely come to respect you. On day one, you and I met, and we definitely, you told me more, you showed me that you listen, that you care. You knew more about my medical conditions than I care to even know. You obviously know how to listen, and you care about it. Absolutely respect that. I absolutely respect you again for your ability to deal with to be very upfront and honest and deal with the alcoholism. Phenomenal. Tremendous inner strength. I absolutely respect you for that. The one issue I do have is that Eric's timing needs a lot to be desired. And unfortunately, the officiant spoke a lot about this already. Eric, when we were down in Alabama, decided that he would spend the time and really looked like he was interested in knowing what I wanted to say to him. He wanted to hear, when should I propose? How should I do it? We all agreed that it should be done after dessert.
But
I'll be done in a minute.
We love you, but we also can't hear you because we're not speaking to you.
the microphone, so I would make one.
Lo and behold to me, when all
statement and then
when all was said and done, Eric decided to do his ceremony with missing two important people, us. Having said that, Eric, you may be changing Rachel's last name to Roach, but let it be known that you are a welcome addition to the Lincoln family. So now we can all stand, raise our glasses, and wish Rachel and Eric Lincoln Roach, congratulations. Congrats.
Yeah, let's go. Come on, pass it around. Keep it going. When is the music gonna stop? We don't know. All right, one person is gone from each table. Here we go.
Work your body, Lina. Work, Sonora. Work it all the time. My girl's name is Sonora. I tell you, friends, I adore her. And when she dances, oh, brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line. Rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line. Rock your body on time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line. Rock your body on time.
Oh, all right, we got two people gone from each table, but here's what we're going to do. We don't have to do this all night, so we don't have time to do that. So I'd like you to give that dollar back to the donor. That's right, the person that took that dollar bill out. Yes, they are the winner of the centerpiece at the tables. Yes, congratulations to the donors. Paul's going to hit the music, and I want table number one to come on up. Here we go, as quick as you can. Have fun. Let's go. Yeah, you got to make those shots fun. Come on. All right, table one is done. I'd like to call up table number two. All right, here we go. Table number three. Come on up. Let's go. Table number three. All right, table four, get ready. All right, table number four, come on up.
Oh, I see a man at the back, as a matter of fact. His eyes are as red as the sun. And the girl in the corner let no one ignore her. She thinks she's the passionate one.
Oh, yeah.
All right, good job, table four. Table number five, come on up, table number five.
And they all started grooving.
Go, come on. Here we go, table number five. All right, table five, thank you. Table number six, let's go. Table number six, where are you at? Yeah, we got 2.5 minutes. Let's go. Yeah, let's go. You got 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
And the girl in the corner is everyone's one. She could kill you with a wink of her eye.
Oh, yeah, table number eight. Table eight, come on up. Let's go. Hurry up. Table nine, get ready. Oh yeah, good job, table eight. Table number nine, come on up, let's go. 1.5 minutes, let's go. All right, table 10, get ready. All right, table 10, let's go. Table 10, come on up, let's go. Real quick.
Was frightening, and the music was soothing.
table number 11. Table 11, let's go. 1 minute. We can do this. Come on. Table 12, get ready. All right, table 12, let's go. Table 12. Yeah, here we go. Nice big kiss. Let's have a nice round of applause for Eric and Rachel, the cake cutting on their wedding day. Congratulations. And ladies and gentlemen, our newlyweds have requested all the couples here tonight come on up and join them.
One word, that's all you say.
Once again, couples, come on up and join them, please.
Something in your voice calls me to turn my head. Your smile just captured me. And you were in my future, far as I could see. And I don't know how it happened, but it happened still. You ask me if I love you, if I always. From hello, I felt love start to grow. The moment that I looked into your eyes, you want me. It was over from the start. You completely stole my heart, and now you won't let go. I never even had a chance, you know. You had me from hello. Inside, I built a wall so high around my heart, I thought I'd never fall. Down. The bricks of my defenses scattered on the ground. And I swore to me I wasn't gonna love again. The last time was the last time I'd let someone in. But you had me from hello. And I felt start to grow. The moment that I looked into your eyes, you want me. It was over from the start. You completely stole my heart, and now you won't let go. I never even had a chance, you know. You had me from hello. That's all you said. Something in your voice called me to turn my head. You had me from hello. You had me from hello.
All right, we got all the single ladies. Take a look around. Make sure we got them all. Dance it up, ladies. All right. Rachel, are you ready? All right. I need everybody to help me count to three nice and loud. And on three, Rachel's going to toss the bouquet to one of the ladies on the dance floor. So, ladies, are you ready? Rachel, are you ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. On three. One, two, three. Oh, there we go. We got a winner. Congratulations. All right, let's give Allie a nice round of applause. Congratulations, Allie. All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to open up the dance floor. We want everybody up and dancing. Yeah. Oh yeah, get those hands up. You know the routine. Come on, clap those hands. Everybody sitting down. Come on, join our dancers. Let's go. Those hands up, everybody. Come on, clap those hands. Go, go, go. Clap, clap, clap. Here we go, sing it.
Never felt so good, it never felt so right. And we're glowing like the metal on the edge of One big happy family. Sing it. Those hands, clap those hands.
There's the windup, and there it is. The line shot up a bit. Look at him go. This boy can really fly. He's rounding first and really turning it on now. He's not letting up at all. He's going to drive the second.
Now, normally I would do like a battle of the sexes. I'd line up the ladies on one side, the guys on the other. But I think if the guys are smart, they're going to let the ladies win this one tonight. So let's keep that circle together. Make some noise for the Brad, everybody! Make some noise for the groom! Ladies, you're up first! That's it, give it to him.
Sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning.
Ladies, are you gonna take that?
Sleep on it. Well, let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning.
I gotta know right now. Do you sleep on it? Will you love me forever?
Let me sleep on it.
Will you never leave me?
Let me sleep on it.
Let me sleep on it.
Let me sleep on it.
Will you love me forever?
Let me sleep on it.
Will you love me forever?
I couldn't take it any longer. I was crazy when the feeling came up on me like a tidal wave. Started swearing to my God and on my mother's grave that I would love it till the end of time. I swore I would love it till the end of time.
Everybody.
So now I'm praying for the end of time.
It's this song.
You, I don't think that I can really survive. I'll never break my promise or forget my vow.
today. Give yourselves a nice round of applause out there on the dance floor, little Meatloaf Paradise.
Night is young and the music's high. With a bit of rock music, everything's fine. You're in the mood for a dance. And when you get the chance.
Oh yeah, here we go, everybody on the D floor, sing it.
You are the dancing queen.
Ladies. Just kidding, you guys can sing. I wouldn't kick you off. But. Alright, she's like thanking me. Alright, let's go 5 years. 5 years or less. We ask that you leave the dance floor, please. Can I have some fun with this song? That didn't do anything. And I gained a couple. Wow. Alright. I got 3 minutes. We're good. All right.
I can't remember.
Let's go 10. 10 years or less. We ask that you leave the dance floor. I'm so sorry. Congrats anyway. Still a good number.
I swear you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone so. But through the years it seems
all right,
to me,
15 years. Let's go 15 years or less. We ask that you leave the dance floor, please.
Through all the good and bad, I know how much we had. I've always been so glad to be with you through the years.
Yes, let's go 20. 20 years or less.
You've kissed my
thank you. Congratulations, guys. Good job. All right, 2-5, the big 25, 25 years or less. We ask that you leave the dance floor. Congrats to you guys. Yes, let's go to 30, the big 3-0, 30 years. All right. We still got two couples out here.
Through the
I never had a
dollar. Oh, wait a minute. We gained a couple. Wow, at 30, that's never happened.
I've learned what life's about.
All right, let's go 35. 35 years or less. All right, let's go 40. 40 years or less. All right, we still got two couples here. All right, 45? Let's go 45 years or less. Oh, now it's getting hairy. All right, I'm going to go 47.
You've never let me down.
48?
You turn my
I'm just scared. What can I say? 50.
The sweetest days I found.
I knew I was close. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give this 50 years happily married couple a nice round of applause. And a little gift from the bride and groom. There you go. Flowers for you. Congratulations. All right, let's get our bride and groom in the middle of the dance floor. Come on up, everybody. Let's get up here on the dance floor. Closing song with our newlyweds. Come on up, everybody.